Hello, Anime Visor here.
And SiGNUM.
With an anime recommendation for Gal and Dino.
What a seemingly weird little anime.
You don't even know the half of it.
Okay.
Anyway, Gal and Dino is based on a manga called My Roomie is a Dino, written by Mori Komori and illustrated by Kota Tamamura. It follows a gal named Kaede, who after a night of drinking, wakes up to realize she now has a dinosaur as a roommate. A literal dinosaur. The easygoing Kaede accepts her new living situation, and now navigates her daily life while eating, watching TV, and shopping with her new prehistoric roommate. Gal and Dino is a short runtime anime. The anime actually began airing back during the spring 2020 season, but due to COVID, new episodes were pushed back to fall of 2020. Each episode tends to be relaxing and fun, despite Kaede's new living arrangements, and it's a big selling point of the anime. It's an anime where you don't have to worry about much drama or any doomsday scenario, and you can just enjoy a gal living with her dinosaur roommate.
Mind explaining to the viewers what exactly is a gal?
Sure thing. First, gal in Japanese is pronounced garu, and garu in general refers to a type of Japanese fashion usually worn by women. Garu fashion is typically characterized by having heavily bleached or blonde hair, tan skin, highly elongated decorated nails, and dramatic makeup. A stereotype that surrounds those who follow the trend is that they lack interest in work or getting married, and are regarded as being childish or a hussy. And over the years, we've seen more and more characters in anime and manga being based on this fashion trend and or the stereotypes associated with it. However, in anime like Please Tell Me Galko-chan, and a manga like Hokkaido Gals Are Super Adorable, have put their own little twist on gal-type characters, and portrayed them in a more positive light. Both shied away from those perceived stereotypes of those type of characters, with Gal and Dino doing a similar thing here with Kaede. Kaede is a very relaxed individual who does seemingly try her best at work, and is very respectful towards others despite her appearance. In general, it seems that she's a very pleasant person to be around, and she has a dinosaur for a roommate, which is pretty cool. Focusing on the anime itself, I do like the character designs. I think it captures the look of the manga fairly well. The anime also features a couple of short skits every episode that are done using stop motion animation. Those segments are short and sweet, and I appreciate the work that must have gone into them. I'm a bit of a sucker for stop motion animation, and seeing those and even the ending animation feature stop motion was a delight to see. All in all, Gal and Dino has been a pleasant experience to watch so far, and if you're interested in checking it out yourself, it's currently streaming over on Funimation.
I guess it's time to wrap up the video?
Au contraire, SiGNUM. Remember when I said you don't even know the half of it?
Yeah.
Well, not only does each episode of Gal and Dino feature an anime about a gal and dino living together, but it also includes the live-action adaptation as well. And if you thought the anime was a bit strange, then take a look at this.
What in the?
While the scenes with Kaede and her dinosaur roommate are still rather wholesome here in the live action version, it just being in live action does really turn up the weird factor. Now you may be thinking, what's the big deal? It's just the live action version of the anime. However, I can assure you that while the premise of the two versions are the same, Kaede waking up with a dinosaur roommate, the stories depicted play out entirely differently, resulted in the live-action version having a more overarching narrative and it being a little bit more of a mystery to what's going on, on top of it just being really weird and absurd. The live-action portion of Gal and Dino really would be right at home on something like Adult Swim. Gal and Dino may not be for everyone, but the anime, with it portraying a Gal character in a positive light while also being fun and relaxing, and the live-action version, while being different, brings its own type of fun and weirdness to the series, I think makes Gal and Dino worth checking out. With all that said, what are your thoughts on Gal and Dino? And are you considering checking it out? Let us know in the comments below. As always, I've been AnimeVisor.
And I've been SiGNUM.
Thanks for watching, and see you later.
Bye-bye.